Now we look at a concept called thrust and pressure. See here, whenever I am looking at the case of thrust and pressure. Let us see what is the difference between this thrust and pressure. Here, thrust is nothing but whenever you have a block. Here, you have a block. When you are applying a force on this block, as an example, here this block has got 6 surfaces, one surface I am looking at, so force is exerted on this block. If at all the force exerted is perpendicular to the surface, so this is the force which is exerted perpendicular to the surface, this is called as the thrust. So, force acting in different angles can be called as the force only, but it can never be called as the thrust. Thrust has to be force acting perpendicular to cross-sectional area. Perpendicular to cross-sectional area is called as the thrust. So, force acting perpendicular to the cross-sectional area is called as the thrust. So, this is what the definition of thrust we can write. Now, coming to the pressure, if at all, we have the area of cross-section of this surface where the force is acting. So, let us say this is the force acting, which you can call as the thrust also, and the cross-sectional area is A. In this case, the pressure can be calculated as pressure is equal to force acting per unit area. That means force divided by area of cross section. So, pressure can be defined as F by A. This is the expression you need to remember. Pressure is equal to force per unit area. So, obviously, its units come out to be Newton per meter square or Pascal. Here thrust units are same as that of the force. Thrust or force, both have the same units represented by newtons. So, two things you need to remember. Thrust is nothing but the force acting perpendicular to the cross-sectional area is called as the thrust, and force acting per unit area of cross-section is called as the pressure. And here, what does it mean by buoyancy? The next question arises, buoyancy can be defined as an upward thrust. For example, whenever a body is floating on a liquid surface, so there exists an upward thrust. That means if it is floating on the surface, then there exists an upward thrust. This upward thrust is called as buoyancy. Upward thrust is called as buoyancy. This is a buoyant force. You can call it as a buoyant force. And here, whenever you consider the fluid pressure, you should also remember one thing, that whenever the fluid is present in a vessel, it will exert force in all directions equally. That means, if at all you have a body placed inside this, then force exerted by the fluid on this body remains same. So, fluid exerts pressure in all directions in equal amounts. That is what we call as the fluid pressure. Similarly, when you consider the walls of the container also, the perpendicular to this, whatever the force experiencing by this wall is same as that of this wall. Similarly, here also fluid exerts the force. That means the force acting per unit area you are calculating as the pressure. So, pressure exerted by the fluid in all directions remain same. And in previous classes, we have studied the pressure at the bottom of the surface is depending only upon the height of the liquid column, but not on the shape of the container. See, here the pressure is same as that of the pressure over here, if at all you take the container to the same level, that means if at all the liquid is present up to this level, then pressure due to this will be same as that of pressure due to this. That means it depends upon only the height. So you need to remember the pressure exerted by the fluid on a body is same in all directions, which is called as the fluid pressure. So three things we can conclude here: the definition of thrust, the definition of pressure, and what does it mean by a buoyant force. Here thrust is nothing but force acting perpendicular to the surface, that is called as the thrust, and force acting per unit area is called as the pressure. If at all fluid is exerting the pressure, or fluid is exerting an upward force, the upward force experienced by a body by means of the fluid is a buoyant force. So upward thrust is nothing but buoyancy. And coming to the fluid pressures, fluid pressure is nothing but the pressure exerted by a fluid element on the walls of a container, on the walls of a body immersed in it, whatever it may be, fluid pressure remains same in all directions. These are the things you need to remember before proceeding for the further definitions or further terms associated with them.